Hello everyone, this is Lata Akula. In this video we are going to study about class amphibians. So where these amphibians came from? We see the classification. So under the subphylum vertebrata, there are two divisions. One division is Ichthyostomata, which we have already completed, where the jawless animals have included. And the second division is Gnathostomata, where the animals which have the strong jaws were included. Under this division, there are two superclasses again. One is superclass Pisces and second one is superclass Tetrapoda. Under superclass Pisces, we have studied about fishes. And in this Tetrapoda, where the animals which have the appendages, paired appendages were included, under this Tetrapoda, there are again four classes. The first class is the amphibian. We see the amphibians. These amphibians, the meaning of these amphibians is amphi means dual and bios means life. That means these animals, they live both on the land and inside the water also. And these are aquatic and terrestrial also. And if you see them, the animals, for example, this is the salamander. It consists of front two limbs and back two limbs. The front two limbs are called as fore limbs. And the back two limbs are called as hind limbs. So they have two pairs of limbs are present in these amphibians, and the body is divides into head and trunk. The body is divides into, this is head and this part is trunk, and in some animals the tail is also present like salamander. In some animals in the larval stages, if you see the frogs, in the most of these amphibians, the larval stages, they have the tail. You see the frog. We have studied the life cycle of a frog in your earlier classes, where the frog larva is called as tadpole larva, which consists of tail, right? After metamorphosis, in the adult frogs, the tail is absent here. And another one is the skin is moist and which is not covered by any scales. In Pisces, we have studied that the body of the fishes was covered by scales. But in these amphibians, those scales are absent, but the skin is highly moist. And eyes. We see the eyes. The eyes are covered with eyelids. And in frogs and toads, behind the eye, there is a tympanum is present, which will represent the ear. So from that tympanum, the sound will enter inside the inner parts of the ear. And this tympanum that covers the ear and protects it from water and other foreign particles. And in this alimentary canal, urinary system and reproductive tracts, they opens into a common chamber which is called as cloaca. By means of this cloaca, that will opens exterior. That means outside. You see the alimentary canal, whatever the waste material, excretory material generated here, and from the urinary canal where the waste water and all will be generated, and from the reproductive tracts like the gametes were generated, they will reach us to the cloaca, which will from the cloaca that will be released out by means of the external aperture called as cloaca. And the respiration is by means of gills, lungs and through the skin. So the respiration by gills that will takes place during larval stages, they respire by gills. Because in the larval stages, these are present in the water. So in the water, they respire by means of gills only. When the animal will metamorphose into adult, in the adults, they may respire either by lungs are through the skin. They respire by the lungs, that is called as pulmonary respiration. If they respire by means of the skin, it is called as cutaneous respiration. So normally these animals, they prefer to respire by skin only. That's why the body of these amphibians are highly moist to absorb the dissolved gases present in the air, and they prefer to respire by skin. But sometimes if they don't get sufficient oxygen by means of cutaneous respiration, they will switch to the pulmonary respiration and respire by means of the lungs. And they consist of heart, which is a three-chambered means it consists of two auricles and only one ventricle. And these are cold-blooded animals, are otherwise called as poikilodermas. So these are poikilodermous animals. That means where these are cold-blooded, they respire by means of they do not have the capability to change their body temperature according to the external environment. Hence, they are called as poikilodermous animals, and these are dioecious. Dioecious means male animal and female animal are separate, and the fertilization is external. External fertilization means what? The fertilization means here the male animal and female animal during reproductive time, they releases their gametes into the water, where the sperms and eggs fuses and fertilization takes place in the water, that is external, outside the body of the female. Hence it is called as external fertilization. And after these are the oviparous. Oviparous means they lay only eggs, and the development is indirect. So after fusion, so from the eggs the larval stages comes. Hence this is indirect development. Examples for these animals are UFO, which is called as toad, rana is called as frog, and hyla is called as a tree frog. If you see, what is the difference between the toad and frog? The toad, if you see the toad, it has a shorter legs compared to the frog. Frog has a larger legs compared to the body. The legs are longer, and the skin of these toads, they are highly dry, and whereas the skin of these frogs are moist. And the frog's legs are made for hopping, and whereas the toad's legs are made for crawling. So that is the difference between the toad and frog. And another one is a salamandra, which is called a salamander. That is an ichthyophis. It is a limbless amphibian. It is just like the worm without having any limbs. This ichthyophis is also called as blind worm. These are the general characters of amphibians. Here, what are the amphibians? Once again, we will revise. Amphi means ritual, bios means life. And these animals, they live both in the water and on external on terrestrial habitat also. And they have two pairs of limbs. They are front two limbs are the forelimbs, and back two limbs are the hind limbs. And the body is divided into head and trunk. In some, the tail is also present. Mostly in the larval stages, tail persists. But in salamander, in adult's form also, the tail will exist. And they have eyes. Eyes are covered with eyelids. In frogs, behind the eyes, there is a tympanum is present, which represents the ear, and they consist of cloaca. Here, from the alimentary canal, urinary tract, and respiratory tracts, all these tracts opens into the external aperture called as cloaca. And they respire by means of gills during the larval stage, and in adults they may respire either by the skin or by means of lungs. And they consist of three-chambered heart, which contains two auricles and one ventricle. And these are the cold-blooded animals. They do not have the ability to control their body temperature according to the surrounding environment. And these are the dioecious animals. That means male and female are separate. And the fertilization is by means of external fertilization, where this takes place in the aqueous conditions. And these are oviparous, that is eggs. And the indirect development, that means the larva stages will be seen. From the larva only, that will metamorphosis into the adult organisms. Examples are the buffo, which is called as toad, and rana, commonly called as frog. Hyla is called as tree frog. Salamandra, which is called as salamander. Ichthyophis, which is called as limbless amphibians. So with this, we have completed the general characters of amphibians. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel, Lata Akula Biology Tutorial. Thank you.